Hi, I'm Caitlin Ryan with Cognizant. Welcome to our Healthcare Interoperability Ask the Expert video series. Today, Adrian DeWitt, Director of Product Portfolio Strategy, will be answering a few questions about the TriZetto Connected Interoperability Solution. Adrian, what products make up the TriZetto Connected Interoperability Solution?
The TriZetto Connected Interoperability Solution is comprised of four different products. The first being the adapter, which does transformation and translation to FHIR format of data from our core admin systems. We've got the data hub, which takes ingestion and aggregates FHIR data from any data source in a FHIR format and prepares it for sending based on the API requests a member makes through a third-party developed app. We have the privacy and consent engine, which helps us manage the fact that we should send the data to the person who's requesting it when the member, in fact, is not requesting their own information. And then finally, we have the API gateway product, which not only provides the actual interoperability APIs, but also provides a developer portal, which allows the third-party developers to register, build and test their applications so that they can distribute those to your members. And we also support all of the security requirements and authentication protocols as defined in Smart on FHIR.
Next, how did Cognizant approach the design and development of the TriZetto Connected Interoperability Solution?
So as we approached the design of the TriZetto Connected Interoperability Solution, you know, we really had a couple things in mind. One was flexibility and the other was going to be timeliness. So as it relates to flexibility within our adapter, we knew that we needed to have that capability to take data that we had in our core admin system, such as QNX and Facets, and teach that to speak FHIR so that that data could be a part of any interoperability solution that you might have. But we also recognize that there's a lot of other data outside of the system of record that we have in QNX and Facets, and that we needed to be able to support all that additional data, things like qualified data in the categories of clinical, additional administrative data, as well as the Part D formulary drug data under the patient access API, and then the provider directory API, and those associated profiles and data sources. So we chose to make the data hub really an ingestion engine that's capable of accepting data from any system of record in a lot of various formats and various methods of being able to post the data into the data hub. So the data hub can ingest data either via SFTP, so secure file loads, HTTPS API posts, as well as streaming and being able to event the data into the data hub upon changes that happen to it. So we really wanted a flexible approach in terms of accessing the data and getting it into the right format, as well as terminology normalizing it. Also on the right side of our solution, where we have that external facing API gateway, we wanted to make that really flexible as well in terms of both that new constituent, which is the third party developer, but also from the perspective of having it fit within different enterprise architecture that you may have. So existing enterprise API management. So flexibility was one key consideration. The other part was around timeliness. So we went with a SaaS delivery model because as interoperability is already proven, it changes frequently and there's a lot of different interpretation going on in the industry. So our goal was really to make sure that in a SaaS-based solution, we could provide to you those features, those changes to regulatory compliance, data mapping, technical formats, security protocols in a timely manner. And those didn't have to be subject to, you know, planning those upgrade cycles on your side. So as we host the subscription, we make sure that all those things are in place. We have that flexibility to deliver that interoperability data, conformance, compliance capability, and those APIs and keep those maintained and current with any regulatory guidance that may come out.
Thanks, Adrian, and thanks for joining us. You can learn more about our interoperability solutions by visiting cognizant.com/interoperability and look for more Ask the Expert videos coming soon.